Hey everyone, welcome back to our Let's Play of Transport Fever. Now, for various reasons, some including the black texture bug, I've had to restart this playthrough, this episode, at least three or four times, and it's driving me crazy. One thing I found here that kind of messed me up last time was we have what I can only call a hole in the ground, right here at Anthony. And that caused me no end of problems. So we're going to try and avoid that. I still want to do what I was going to do nearby, but I want to try and move it a little bit. But you can't cover it over. You can't raise the land over it. You can't do anything like that with it. So just beware. If you see a hole in the ground like that, stay away from it. So anyway, last episode, we started setting up a steel mill over here at Turawina. And we've got the steel mill, we have the ore mine, and I thought I'd seen a coal mine over here, but it was actually a quarry. So I found a coal mine over here and had to build a road around the back of the mountain, over the mountain and around. But we've got all the stuff we need to make steel, so that's great. Just right now, we don't have anywhere to ship the steel, so there's no demand for steel because nothing's using it. And as far as this quarry is concerned, we happen to have a construction material plant right next to it. So I figured, well, I'll just have it ship the stone down to there and we'll make construction materials. And again, there's no demand for it because nowhere is using it. The towns will use it on their own, so we can get rid of the construction materials pretty easy and create a demand. But steel is going to be a little harder. So the first thing I wanted to do was basically to reverse this road. Well, not this road, but this line. It's currently going between these two and then up into Turawina, which is all right because it gives us somewhere to fill up our construction materials, but it's not ideal. So down here near Kenilworth, down just off the camera, I'm going to put in a truck stop, not a bus station. And we'll just make it a small truck stop, and we'll turn it around and we'll put it right opposite Kenilworth to make it easy to get in and out of. And that's where we're going to take our construction materials. So now that I've done that, let's change this line around. So we don't want them going up to Turawina. We'll remove that. I do want to rename these locations because then I'll know what they are. So this one is the Turawina Quarry. And this one is Kenilworth Construction. And the one over here is going to be Kenilworth Cargo. I guess sidings is kind of appropriate, but I find if I name them this way, I know what I'm dealing with. Right, so let's get rid of that and go back up here. Now, this quarry line needs to go from the quarry, so let's get rid of construction, from the quarry to construction, then it needs to go down here to Kenilworth Cargo, and because we're going to be bringing slag from the steel mill down here, it then needs to go back up to the construction facility to dump the slag. So that's where that line's going to go. We also need one because the steel mill, all the vehicles on the steel mill are only servicing the steel mill. We don't want them going too far away. We want to keep them near the steel mill. So I'm going to make another line from Turawina Central down to Cargo, and that's how they'll take the steel down there. So So we need to find the depot. We need to buy a bunch of road vehicles. Awesome car. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Look at that. I can count. Oh my god. And we need to set them on a new line, which will be road freight. Road freight. Freight, because I've got no imagination. I keep closing those. All right, so we need to basically set it onto the Tour Arena freight line. And then we need to actually modify the Tour Arena freight line, so we'll have to bring it up this way. That one. Right, and now we can add stations. We'll add that station. And we'll add this station, and that should be us. Now, I did notice just now that I had a line that I didn't rename, and I think I'm not actually using it. Yeah. So let's just delete that line because it is not required. Right. So here comes all our vehicles out of the depot, and they're going to head down to remain a cargo. They've got nothing to take at the moment because there's no demand for steel, but we're going to create that. Okay, so I toyed around with the idea of running some ships up here. I did that in the previous recording of this episode, but I kind of changed my mind, and I think I'm actually going to set up a rail line. Because with a rail line, we can get some passengers going as well. Now, I'm not totally sure how I'll do this, but I figure I can set up a rail line down here, and I'm just going to put the freight in to start with. And it can be a terminal station because we've got nothing really beyond here. We turn it around a little bit. Make it a little bit more parallel to the road and put it about there and hook it up with a small country road because that's all we really need. And if I remember rightly, this should connect. Yes, it does. Good. So I forgot to actually make it a double platform, so we'll upgrade it to a double platform. Yeah, gotta hit apply, and there we go. So we're almost out of money again, but I think this is going to be a worthwhile investment, so I'm going to actually get a bank loan and continue on. Now, with this line, I figure we can also run passengers. What I'm trying to do is set up a main line that goes along the river. And I keep forgetting that I've explained all this in another failed attempt at making an episode, so you guys don't know about this yet. But we've got Thomastown right down the end here, and Mount Knowles here, which you're familiar with. So I figured Aru here, Anthony here, I figured we'd just make a main line straight down the river. And we can run both passengers and freight on that, and then we can branch off to go to the other towns and whatever. So we'll take out a bank loan. You can see our cash is going up pretty quick because I've got quite a lot going on now, but I still don't have steel. So let's take out a bank loan, and I'm going to pause it real quick because it's almost the end of the month and I don't want to waste any of this money. Right, so let's take the inside line, extend that out. I just want to go down to Anthony at the moment. I'll show you in a minute, but Anthony has a machine factory, so that will actually create a demand for the steel, because they need steel to operate. I want to keep this as straight as I can. I don't want to slow the trains down too much. although obviously I'm not doing a good job of keeping it straight. That was expensive. I should have watched, or I should have looked before I hit OK on that one. Alright, so keep going down this way. I'm just watching the line speeds to keep it straightish. As long as I got 120, I should be good. Down here now, we're getting in towards Anthony. Now this hole here really messed me up last time. So I want to sort that out before I start. So what I was going to do was I was going to get a medium street. I was going to run this down here. Run that down there. And I can't. And it's because of the hole. So let's go around it. And I want to try and go across that way. And again, because of the hole. No, it's not going to let me. Alright. So we'll get rid of that one. Maybe I can go up above it. No, it's going to make me go up here. Alright, so let's go a little further down. I've got to leave some room for a railway station as well. Actually, for a couple of railway stations. Maybe this isn't going to work. The reason I was going to do it down here was because, yeah, let's abandon that idea. The reason I was going to do it down here was because this is where, all the industry is. Look at this, all the industry's over on this side, and I was going to have a little street across here and have it hook up that. I think I'm just going to stay away from that hole. But what I do want, and I'm still thinking, and I might actually change the plan again. What I do want is to service this industry and as much of the commercial as I can, and I was gonna put the station down here. So I might try that. I might also have to put a truck stop in. That's the only problem. It just depends on how much of the town the station's gonna service, and I can't put it exactly where I wanted it because of that damn hole. So we'll take a two platform station and we'll spin it around so that it matches up with and see if I can't. That's not going to do all the industry there, and I don't want to put it up much higher because that's going to mess me up with the hole. We do want to eventually continue on this way, so ideally an angle like that might be all right, but I can't put it there because of the hole. So if I put it here, you know what, I'm just going to put it over here and hook that road up and just have trucks bring it in, bring the stuff in. So I'm going to have to turn it a bit because I want to avoid that hole. I bring it back a little bit, try and straighten it out. And I'm going to have to build a whole bunch of streets around it, but you know, that's just the way it is. So let's bring the track down into here. And we want to go onto that side because that's where it was. Right, so we've got that much. Now, we need to hook it up, so let's build a few little streets. Let's take a small street from here and wipe out a building. and then continue that over here. Take a medium street down this way. Fill up with a bit more small street. We can probably take a small street through here. I'm gonna wipe out more buildings because I didn't realize there was buildings there. It looked like all green, it looked like trees. So yeah, we want another street. Let's make it a medium. Coming off here, going up this way. We'll extend that down the other way and then connect this up. I think I'm going to take this down here. Right, take it around that way. That lined up looks close enough to me. And we'll do that. Now we need a truck stop. And I'm just going to run trucks. Over into the industrial and commercial area. Now, I may just wipe out a little bit of commercial so that I can get this in the center of town, because it does look like a nice little spot over there. Can I fit a big one in? No, let's put in a little one. And we'll put it. I keep doing that. So truck stop, little one, and M&N, not B. So we're going to knock out six buildings, and it's going to cost me a crap ton of money. Right over here. I'm going to knock out four buildings there, but it looks like it's going to also cost me a crap ton of money. Okay, what about here? I have an idea. I will send this for the small street, and it's going to knock out two buildings. Great. So let's get another bank loan up to 7 million now, and we'll make it a medium street. And since we're taking out two buildings anyway, we'll just put it through here. And we'll put the truck station in here. Now, how much coverage does that give it? Well, that's actually pretty darn good. So we'll put that there, and yeah, I'm going to wipe out another building. Or two. We do actually get a little more coverage that way. So I'm going to call that worth it. And there's that. Now, the other thing we're going to need is a bridge over to here, and a road, and a little truck stop, and all sorts of stuff. So let's get out our medium street. Actually, we'll start off with a bit of small country road, or actually medium country road. Over, not like that. Okay, that's more like it. Oops, geez. Start off over this way, heading over this way, and we'll extend this out a bit, so we'll upgrade to medium street. Oh, now where are we? Okay, so now we want medium street going over this way, So I don't want it curved like that. I like it. I'll bring that out to here. And then we will make a bridge. Too high. Let's just go halfway. And it's more money than we've got, but we'll lift that there and take out another bank loan. I swear, I'm going to owe so much money by the time this is done. So, yeah. Now, we'll come from here across, and we'll go down a couple. Looks about right. Let's make sure it's relatively straight. Well, actually, it is kind of facing where we want to go, and make sure that there's a gap in the middle for the shipping. That'll do. I'm not sure if I can upgrade that bit of bridge, but I like the look of this one better, so I'm going to do that. Now let's see if I can upgrade that. No. Well, it's only money, right? Yep, another bank loan. And we'll make it like that, same as the other one. That's a bit better. And then we'll join it down onto, yeah. And hook up a truck station. Right, so when I hook these up, that should actually create a demand for steel. And then, you know, as I extend the line further down along the river, more and more places will demand steel. Once I get it to Roo, we can actually ship the steel on the ships across the lake, so that'll be awesome. I just realized I'm going to have to take this bridge, this train, through the bridge. But yeah, we'll deal with that when we get there. So, got one track. We need to duplicate that. I do like the way this game lets you duplicate track. I like the way it snaps to the other piece of track. That's really awesome. It makes it so much easier. Take that under there. Right, now we want the trains to be able to cross over here, so we're going to put crossing in. Now I usually extend these out until they're about, I don't remember how much it was, I think it was about 5k. That looks like probably good enough. Let's say 3k. We've got 2.96k there. Start this one here and we'll go 2.96k the other way. That's close enough. And we've got a nice little crossing. So now we need to signal it We want the trains to be going this way on that side. Okay, so what's going on here? Ah, okay. So why is my track all red and I can't lay signals? Like, what is up with that? I can't even see where there is the other signal that I placed, or signals. I can't even remember if I placed one or two. Well, this is certainly no good. You know, I have re-recorded this and re-recorded this over and over again. Right there on that sleeper is where I put it, and it's just not there. Although it's saying I can't put one there, so I think it thinks there's one there. But I can't click it and adjust it, because you can normally click the signals and make them one-way signals and stuff like that. All right, so, oh look, the signals. Okay, so you can edit the name. And you, how do you delete them? I wonder. Oh, you would bulldoze them, wouldn't you? There we go. All right. So that one, we can't see it, but we'll just pretend it's there. We'll make it a one way. And we need another one on this side. So yeah, basically we're going to work around this problem. It needs to be on this side of the track. Zoom out and I can see it. Looks like it is. Yeah, we're going to work around this problem, but this is like an example of the kind of stuff that's been making me have to re-record these episodes over and over again. All right, so down at the other end, we need the same kind of deal. We need some track crossover. We'll go about 3k down the road, and then from the same place, and back about 3k, and we'll put in a starting signal here and a one-way signal here, and then zoom out. Yes. Right. So that should be it for signals. You know what? I didn't make this a long platform. So I need to upgrade that to 320 meters. And that's messed everything else up. Okay. Okay, so upgrade that, make it 320 meters, apply, and now we need to realign the track. And of course, I've got no money. So here we go again, yet another bank loan. Yep. Go back a little further because I need to get it in there. So get the track out. All right, no signals. Need to go from here to there. And on the other side, great, I can't scroll. Right. now let's try that again. We need to make crossover about 3k long, and then again on the other side, it does actually snap where you want it, where you want to be starting. That works, and now we'll put in a invisible signal just here, and another one just here, and then we'll make that one a one way, and that should be us. Right, so what have we got going now? We've got all that. We need a train and we need trucks in here. So I'm not going to make them drive all the way down here, because they're horse and carts, they'll take forever. I'm going to put a depot in over here. And for the time being, let's just get, well, actually, I'm going to go over here. So let's get 10. And create a new line. And we'll call it RF Anthony Deal. So it's going to go over to the thing anyway. So we want them to go. If we can move that out of the way. From here to here and across to here. And that should be it, I think. Now we want to rename that so I know what it is. Anthony Machines. And we'll turn it on because it's been on pause for a long, long time now. You guys must be getting really bored watching me just build. That one will be Anthony Central. And that one will be Anthony Cargo. And we're not quite done. We still need to put in a train so that these guys have something to actually haul. So we will put a depot in. Down here. Now I'm trying to think where I want the depot. Let's put it over here at Anthony, because I want it to come in on this side. The railway depot, spin it around, and we'll put it next to the station. And we'll put in a track. And here, we want to go just beyond the crossing here. Have it join in over here on that side. And if, in case we have trains coming the other way that need to get into the depot, we'll put a crossing in just here. Now this means more signals. to protect everything, so we'll take one of our crappy invisible signals and we'll put it right there. And if he's coming out and someone's going that way, that's okay. If someone's crossing, they need to stop while he comes out. So these signals aren't going to be right because I just really can't be bothered with this bloody bug. So I'm just going to put a signal here. That's interesting. Made that hole. Anyway, put a signal there and be done with it, because that needs to stop trains coming this way from crossing over if there's something coming the other way. Alrighty. So, let's go buy some trains. And again, I'm going to need a bloody loan. Let's borrow some more money. That. Alright, what trains do we have? So we want locomotives, we've only got one, which is yeah, okay, 30 tons, 15 kilonewton tractive effort. Well, it's going to have to do because we've only got one, so we'll just buy one. And now we're going to need some wagons. So, for steel, we are going to need open wagons, I think. Coal, iron ore, stone and grain. Nope. Goods wagon, it ain't that one. Stake car. There we go, stake car. Steel. Steel planks and construction material. Perfect. So let's buy five of those. Oh, 125k. Four of those? We might just be able to squeeze out five if we wait a little bit. Let's see. We're going to get to 125k. I think we might. Almost there. There we go. 125k. So we'll create a new line. And we will call it train freight Anthony to what was that town called? Kenilworth. Kenilworth. That'll do. And we want to add stations, so we'll say go from there. Actually, no, we don't. We want to remove that, because the first station it needs to stop at is up here. So we want to add this one, which, like, I already added it. Remove that. And then we want it to go... Look, there it is already. We want it to go here. It's amazing how you can see anything in this game. With all the windows everywhere. So we want it to go there. And then return. So that's that done. Get rid of this guy. Okay, so now, once he gets up there, he should recognize, or the steel mill should recognize the demand, and the trucks should bring it down from the steel mill. I think we put a bunch of trucks in along there. I hope we did. I mean, there's demand for construction material, so I guess we did. Now he should cross over here. And he does. What a lovely smoke. Follow him. So here's our lovely train. This is our first train, and hopefully it will be the first of many. Well, that's where I'm going to leave this episode. Join me again for the next episode, and we'll see the steel being moved around. and the line extender and all that sort of good stuff, and hopefully we might even have the signals back, but I'm not too hopeful on that one. So yeah, take care, like if you like the video, subscribe if you want to, and bye now.